the last topic in this series is fiscal stimulus. Fiscal stimulus is defined as the use of fiscal policy to increase production and employment. This policy aims to shift the aggregate demand curve by changing government spending or taxes. However, as we saw in the previous video, changes in the tax rate affects the supply side as well. There are two types of fiscal policy: automatic and discretionary. Automatic fiscal policy involves no government action. There are already measures in place which stabilize the economy's fluctuations. We'll get into more detail on that in the next slide. Discretionary fiscal policy is the use of government policy to change aggregate demand. Again, I will get into more detail on this and that in a minute. Automatic fiscal policy, as I mentioned, does not require any sort of government intervention to help stabilize the economy. This works because tax revenues and transfer payments change automatically in response to the state of the economy. Tax laws specify percentage amounts of income that need to be paid as tax and not dollar values. The actual dollar value of tax paid depends on a person's income. Since income varies with real GDP, tax revenue varies with real GDP as well. During an expansion, people's incomes increase, thus they pay more taxes. In the same way, during a period of recession when people's income falls, they pay less taxes. The government doesn't intervene and change the tax rate for the population, but this happens automatically. Keep in mind that the tax rate itself doesn't change, but the dollar amount that people pay in taxes does. The same concept applies with transfer payments. During expansion, when people earn more, the government spends less on transfer payments. During a recession, when people earn less, the government spends more on transfer payments. Taxes and transfer payments are two automatic elements of fiscal policy. Because revenues fall and outlays increase in a recession, the government budget provides automatic stimulus to shrink the recessionary gap. Revenues rise and outlays decrease in an expansion, and the budget provides automatic stimulus to shrink the inflationary gap. The graph on the slide right now shows the most ideal outcome of automatic fiscal stimulus. This does not generally occur. The gap will generally shrink, but long-run macroeconomic equilibrium is generally not achieved solely through automatic fiscal stimulus. Discretionary fiscal policy focuses on changing aggregate demand by focusing on tax rates and government spending. However, cutting taxes, as we explored in a previous video, affects the supply side and crowds out investment. The government needs to keep that in mind when it comes out with a fiscal stimulus package. The government also needs to take into account the multiplier effect that follows any form of a change in autonomous spending. If it increases government spending, consumption will be induced, which will shift the aggregate demand curve more than solely the amount of the change in government expenditure. Government spending will increase incomes, which will increase consumption, and so on. Increases in government borrowing, which the government will need to do if it plans to increase spending, will raise the real interest rate and decrease investment. The demand side effects of a tax cut are likely to be smaller than an equivalent increase in government expenditure because only a part of an increase in disposable income is spent on consumption. Some income is saved and spent on imports, which does not increase the domestic country's real GDP. Ideally, when a fiscal stimulus package is passed, an increase in the expenditure aims to increase aggregate demand by the amount of the change in spending. The multiplier effect further increases aggregate demand, ideally until long-run macroeconomic equilibrium is reached. When the government becomes concerned about its growing debt, it may choose to raise taxes or reduce spending. In this situation, the exact opposite process takes place. Aggregate demand reduces by the amount of the change in spending and the multiplier effect that occurs as a result of a decrease in incomes and consumption. The economy will theoretically return to its previous position, creating a recessionary gap. While fiscal policy does seem like a good idea during recessionary and inflationary periods, it has its drawbacks. Taxes on wages and capital decrease short-run aggregate supply. With less savings and investment, the growth rate of real GDP slows. Some economists claim that the supply-side effects of a tax cut are much larger than those on the demand side. This makes it much harder to achieve the desired outcome of long-run macroeconomic equilibrium. Another valid point argues that when the government increases its expenditure as part of a fiscal stimulus package, it crowds out investment. The government borrows money from the loanable funds market, increasing the demands for loanable funds, and thus the interest rate. Investment slows as a result. It is also very difficult to determine the amount by which taxes should be changed or the amount by which government spending should be changed. The actual output gap, another word to describe either a recessionary or inflationary gap, is very hard to guess and can only ever be estimated. There are also three time lags which greatly impact the effectiveness of a government's fiscal policy. Recognition lag is the time it takes to figure out what fiscal policy actions are needed. The current and future states of the economy need to be assessed before it is even possible to determine what exactly needs to be done. Lawmaking lag is the time it takes a government to pass laws. The problem here is that because democratic governments must put these policies to a vote, by the time any bill gets passed, the state of the economy might have completely changed and a completely different form of stimulus might be needed. The third and last time lag is known as impact lag. Impact lag is the time it takes from passing a fiscal stimulus package to the law actually having an effect. Induced spending, for example, does not occur the day of a change in government expenditure. It happens after incomes increase, which happens after profits increase, and so forth. That was the lecture on fiscal policy.